Hi, questions in mechanics in this textbook. Problem 4.66. Determine the reactions at B and D when D equals 60 millimeter in this figure. Solution. We have lengths DG, BG, GH, BH, AE, AH. Then, we have tangent alpha. So alpha is equal to this value. We have this figure. From this figure, we get those equations. Then we get the results. Problem 4.75. Member ABC is supported by a pin and a bracket at B and by an inextensible cord touched at A and C and passing over a frictionless pulley at D. The tension may be assumed to be the same in portions AD and CD of the cord for the loading shown in this figure. And neglecting the size of the pulley, determine the tension in the cord and the reaction at B. Solution, we get tangent alpha and tangent beta. So we get alpha and beta. We have this figure. From this figure, we get the following equations. Then we have this equation. So we get the tension T. Then we get the reaction FB. Problem 4.84. A slender rod of length L is attached to collars that can slide freely along the guards shown in this figure. Knowing that the rod is in equilibrium, derive an expression for the angle theta in terms of the angle beta. Solution. Let C be the center of the rod. Then we see the length of CD. From the figure, we have this equation. This says this one. This gives this one. So we have this one. This gives this one. This says this result. Problem 4.85. An 8 kilogram slender rod of length L is attached to collars that can slide freely along the guards shown in this figure. Knowing that the rod is in equilibrium and that beta equals 30 degrees, determine A, the angle theta that the rod forms with the vertical, B, the reactions at A and B. Solution, by the problem 4.84, we have this one. So tangent theta equals 2 tangent 30 degree. So we get theta equals this value. We have the weight of the rod. We have this equation. So the reaction FB is equal to this value. And the reaction FA is equal to this value. Problem 4.89. A slender rod of length L and weight W is attached to a collar at A and is fitted with a small wheel at B shown in this figure. Knowing that the wheel rolls freely along a cylindrical surface of radius R and neglecting friction, derive an equation in theta L and R that must be satisfied when the load is in equilibrium. Solution. From the figure, we have equations star. We see AO is given by this one. Then we get CO equal to this one. Then EO is equal to this one. We have those equations for the equilibrium. This gives this one. So we have this one. By equation star, we get this one. This gives this one. This sees this result. Thanks for watching. Bye.